Motion, Part 1. Motion along a straight line. In this video, we will learn about motion along a straight line and about the concepts of distance and displacement. Let's carefully observe the world around us. We can see cars moving on the road, people walking, birds flying, etc. All of them have something in common. They are all moving from one place to another. So, they are in motion. More scientifically, how can we define motion? If an object changes its position with respect to time, it is said to be in motion. But sometimes, it isn't simply clear whether the object is in motion or not. For example, if you are traveling on a train, a person sitting next to you is stationary, according to you. But for someone standing on the road, observing the moving train, the same person is in motion. Why do you think this happens? It is because we define motion of an object with respect to a reference point called the origin. Motion are of many types, like circular motion, linear motion, oscillatory motion, etc. While observing the motion of an object, we have to calculate certain parameters like path covered, time taken, and speed during motion. So, first let's discuss about path measurement. There are two physical quantities related to path measurement: distance and displacement. We can take an example to understand the difference between the two quantities more clearly. Suppose a train starts its journey from station O. We are considering station O as a reference point. Its first stop is 60 kilometers away from O, which is station B. From station B, it travels 90 kilometers to finally reach station A. Now, can you tell what is the total distance traveled by the train? The total distance traveled by the train is 60 kilometers plus 90 kilometers, that is 150 kilometers. For displacement, we must know that it is the shortest distance between the initial and the final position. Since we are considering the train is moving in the straight line, so the displacement is equal to the distance. So the displacement is also equal to 150 kilometers. Now, on the same day, it has to return to station O. It starts from station A and reaches back to station O via station B. The total distance covered by the train is 150 kilometers plus 150 kilometers is equal to 300 kilometers. Now, the initial and final positions are the same. Hence, the total displacement of the train will be equal to zero. So, now we can understand what we mean by distance and displacement. Distance is the total path traveled from the starting point to the end point. And the shortest path measured from the initial point to the final point of an object is known as the displacement. Always remember that the magnitude of displacement is less than or equal to the distance. Let's look at another example. Imagine you are sitting on a seat in a giant wheel. Right now you are at the bottom. After half a rotation, you reach the top of the giant wheel. Can you find out what your displacement from the initial position is? Here, displacement is equal to diameter of the giant wheel. Once again, the wheel starts rotating. When it finally stops, you are again at the bottom. Can you determine your displacement till here? Here, displacement is equal to zero, since your initial position and final position are the same. In this video, we learnt about motion along a straight line and about the concepts of distance and displacement. In the next video, we will learn about uniform and non-uniform motion.